just relaxing and creating a little diorama, as they call it, with no goal or management or rules. I've never played this before, but I am very excited to jump into it and see what we can come up with. So I hope you will kick back and relax and enjoy Tiny Glade. I guess let's go through this little thing they're telling me to do here. Rotate camera. Okay, so I noticed we can actually start exploring the interface. What does this do? Okay, that puts down water, I see. Okay, awesome, we have an undo button. That places a structure. That's path. Looks like that's decorations. Oh my god. I'm gonna get very addicted to this game. Okay, so I'm gonna erase what's already here. And I had kind of an idea in mind. This is a door where there's a path. Okay. Control-C, Control-V doesn't seem to do anything. So, I guess I just have to keep doing it by hand. It's this to really make the interface easy to use and intuitive, and they have nailed it. As a UX designer myself, who deals with making tools intuitive for all people, so far I have no complaints. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna spend all day on here. I do have a complaint, actually. I really would like copy and paste. Is it gonna put a bird's nest on every single one of these? What the heck? support pillars. That's cute. Ah, the glare. Help. Just gonna add all kinds of structures, or I guess like geometry, maybe make it look just really whimsical. Start adding some details. Okay. Ah, I see, I see. Very interesting. So let's use these. Let's use these windows. Thank you. Hogwarts Castle. This game. Okay, let's try painting. What if we do a kind of that kind of brick for these walls? I'm sure I will get tons of tips in the comments about. So lost the plot. Okay, I think we're good now. And for the castle itself, or the little manor, yes. Help me engage.